welcome to the season finale of Real Debates Season 3. Oh my gosh, this has been such a fun season. I'm not going to lie to you. I feel like I shot this season back in 2020. But I'm so glad to get to the near end of this. We've had so much fun doing it. And I felt like for a season, the last episode for this season, we had to go out with the bang. So as you guys know, the end of season 2, it was Martin versus essentially Will Smith, but Fresh Prince versus The Martin Show. And, you know, there it was a major funny debate. I think, you know, Real Debates has become a comedy in a sense. And yeah. I felt like to end season 3, we had to go with, for today's topic at least, what is the best Will Smith movie? Now, I have a picture of him on my wall. I love The Fresh Prince. I love his movies. Ian's a huge fan of Will Smith as well. And for today, since the topic is what's the best Will Smith movie, I'll be repping the movie Hitch. And Ian will be repping the movie I Am Legend. And Jeremy will be giving us his due to moderate us. And I can't wait to get into it. This is going to be an explosive match. Before I pass it to Jeremy, I'm going to break down the rules. The rules are very simple. 3 rounds. 2 minutes per round. Each competitor has 2 minutes to state their case in the first round. Second round is the battle round where we go at each other. In the third round, we wrap everything up. Now we have a special round that we introduced for this season called Sudden Death, which you guys witnessed last episode, where if the moderator, which is Jeremy, if he feels like we're evenly matched, he can give us one more round, and that round will be 1 minute per competitor. Now that I've gotten all the rules out of the way, Jeremy, you take it away.
All right. As he said, 2 minutes per each round. First one, kind of set up why yours is good. Second round, why the opponent's is bad. Third round, we're kind of tying up loose ends. You guys know the drill at this point. But yeah, it's awesome. We're bringing it back to the people that started this thing in the first place to wrap up the third season. So, yeah, should be a good debate. I'm getting my timer set up right now, and I want to ask each opponent, I believe Ian won last time. So, Ian, a number between 1 and 20, please.
1 and 20. I'm going to go with 12.
Well, that's a good number. Alex?
13.
Ian was closer with the number being 11. So, Ian, oh, wow. Would you like to go first, or are you going to go second?
Absolutely. I came for the disrespect on this man's show.
All right. Here we go. Then I'm going to start the counter in 3, 2, 1, go.
So I want to start this debate by saying, like, you know, Will Smith gets a lot of flack for not having the most decent movies in the last 5-10 years. But looking at his filmography, he is a whole legend. Like, some of his movies, like, he doesn't have to make good movies the rest of his life. He's got classics. And what makes him a legend, to me, he was already a legend before this came out, but this one right here made him an icon, goddess status. This was I Am Legend. I Am Legend is something I believe that came out in 07 or 08, one of those 2 years. And this is a movie about an apocalyptic future because of a virus that killed off 99% of humanity. And he was, so he thought, one of the only left survivors, and he was working on a cure. And to me, watching this in 2022, it's like, wow, this could have been us a couple of years ago. Taking away my thoughts about this, I thought this performance from Will Smith was next level. You know, every movie back then, it seemed like he upped it up. You know, it started with the Fresh Prince episode, when, you know, that father episode, and then it came to, I believe, Pursuit of Happiness, and then I Am Legend. He just amped it up every time.
I can save you. I can help you. You are sick, and I can help you.
And there's a scene, I was rewatching I Am Legend actually today. My son watched it for the first time, when he kills his dog. His dog ended up getting infected by another dog. It wasn't from having sex. It was from, you know, getting bitten. And he had to kill it. This is the only communication and only, like, part of life he had before this virus. And he had to do it, you know, just because he didn't want the dog to kill him. And, you know, didn't want to have this dog living in an infection. On the scene after that, he talks to a mannequin, because he's so lonely.
Morning, Hank. Midway through the G's.
Hey. This man was a one-man show for 90% of the movie. That right there shows talent. That right, not many actors can just do a whole movie by themselves.
Usually, is it for round one. Really well done. You had some good stuff that you touched on there, Ian, from Smith being a legend to ending up in a movie called I Am Legend. You talked a bit about what the movie's about and compared it to the pandemic. You talked about his performance and it being a one-man show. I think that was a really good round. Alex, how you feeling, man? You ready for this?
I am ready.
He ain't ready. He ain't legend.
Oh, okay. We'll see.
All right. And I'm going to start this timer in 3, 2, 1.
All right. So I chose my movie Hitch because we've seen Will Smith, to Ian's point, do a lot of legendary things, from primarily action roles, drama roles, and even comedy stuff. If you want to call Fresh Prince comedy, he did that type of stuff as well. But when you look at Hitch is a movie where he's trying to teach men who don't think they have a chance to be with the women that they want, to tell them that everything is all in your control. And the funny thing I love about Hitch is that this is the very first time we see Will Smith be the coach, in a sense where every person that he is mentoring and trying to get women to not necessarily like them, but to accept those men for who they are, he just tells them, in a sense, to be themselves, but also do little things here and there to make yourself noticeable.
Good. You ever heard of Michelangelo?
Yeah.
Heard of Sistine Chapel?
Yeah.
The underlying thing about Hitch is that every person that he's ever coached is a reflection of himself, because it starts off where he went through a bad breakup that he was with, and he was very eager and young, and he vowed for that to never happen to him again. So he went after the same particular men who are going through the same thing. And these are not men who don't have successful lives, but these are men who have jobs, businesses, things of that nature, who can't find love. And he basically coached them.
You know, you're mad at me for what I do for a living?
Look, I've already got your number, so why don't you go consult your conscience?
But the funny thing about it is that he became really great friends with Albert Brenneman. The relationship that they had in that whole movie was amazing, and there was a lot of great comedic moments. And also, the very thing that he was coaching him through, he was going through by trying to get this other woman who was essentially investigating him and thinking that he was just some con man when he really wasn't. He was trying to teach men to get women.
And time, Alex. That is 2 minutes and another good round. You made a lot of good points in there. You talked about how Smith has worked through several genres. You talked about the plot of the movie. You mentioned how he's kind of a mentor and a reflection of a lot of the clients that he's got in this one. And talked about the comedic moments. I think that was a really good first round. Because Ian started off the first round, Alex is going to come and start the second round. This is the round that we normally call the battle round. And the reason is because we take the opportunity typically to go in on the opponent's film. So instead of talking about why yours is good, you're talking about why the other one's bad. Alex, you know the deal. We got 2 minutes on the clock in 3, 2, 1, and go.
I could talk about how trash I Am Legend is, but I'm going to do what Ian's already planning to do with my movie. So yeah, Hitch is not that funny. Yes, Hitch has a lot of inconvenient moments and inconsistencies in the movie. And yes, Hitch, in a sense, doesn't make any sense in terms of, you know, going out to these very wealthy men and coaching them to do all these great things. So what if Hitch has a coming of age story? So what if Hitch is a great monumental movie to have men to get out of their own heads that want to talk to other women? I bet you Ian right now is going to say Hitch is a perfect example of little dick energy. Probably so. Who knows? But at the end of the day, I can say that if anything is a representation of little dick energy, it's I Am Legend, because Will Smith.
Damn!
It's bitched up because he couldn't find the cure. He was the cure the whole time. His dumbass didn't even know. He lost his damn dog. And not only that, the woman that he was with, that was trying to help him. He literally fought her the whole time. They like arguing with her and not trying to find a solution.
Doesn't matter how it makes you feel.
So now that I've said all that, Ian, tell them something else they don't know about my movie.
So Alex took a very different approach this time. He went full rabbit and has decided that he was going to attack his own movie, which that's an interesting perspective. I like it. Very disarming in many ways. I don't know what to do with it. Ian, how are you feeling, man?
I'm feeling great. A lot of his criticism I wasn't even going to say, but okay. I have my own.
Little dick energy. Got to write that down real quick.
Little dick energy.
That shit is funny.
Well, technically, had the biggest dick around because nobody else was there. So,
congratulations, you played yourself.
Oh, that's a fair point. A lot of people don't think about it in those terms. I'm into that. All right, here we go. Ian. Oh man, round two. In three, I don't even know what to say, bro. In 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, I guess I'll reiterate. Little dick energy, he had the biggest dick because he was the only guy there, except for this little boy. If that little boy had a bigger dick than Will Smith, then wow, props to him. But enough of little boy penis. Let's talk about Hitch. I'm not going to agree with what he said about me saying that Hitch is a trash movie. I was actually going to say I love Hitch. I think Hitch is great. The problem with Hitch, though, it just feels like a movie I've seen before. There's the tropes of like the guy trying to get the girlfriend and, you know, getting coached by the cool guy. Yes, I've never really seen a movie with a date coach before, so that might be a little bit original, but the whole concept of the weirdo loser trying to get the girl, yeah, it's been done before. And then
what more do you want from me?
And the cool guy being awkward to try to get the girl and it's just not working out for him. Yeah, I've seen all that before. So like, that's my issue with Hitch. It's funny, it's great, but is it really that original? Like, you know, it's got that funny dance scene with a fat guy. Yeah, we've never seen that before, Chris Farley. But I think I Am Legend took a lot more work and depth to do. I think that's obvious. Will Smith seemed like he was just being Will Smith and Hitch. Nothing wrong with that. Will Smith does a great job being Will Smith and making money, but he actually had to try with I Am Legend. He actually had to be emotional. He actually had to be angry, empathetic. Sad. And all that stuff. He had to fight with freaking zombies. He had to, you know, be tactical. He had to work with a fucking dog. Yeah. Yeah, I'm more impressed with him working with a dog than Kevin James' fat ass. So that's my thing right there.
And the guy was a bum. He didn't seem like a very nice person to me.
Your movie has funny, iconic moments. Of course, I mentioned the dance scene. I laugh at that all the time. I mimic it all the time. But does your movie have a scene where he has to kill a dog? Does your movie have a scene where he just gave up on life and he just tries to kill himself by taking as much zombies? No. Does he have a scene where he goes all out with a grenade
and that's
blows
it.
The motherfucker up?
And that's it. Well done, man. Well done. Ian brings up a good point. Will Smith does have the biggest dick in I Am Legend.
Hear anything else I said.
That's it. That's the only note I got from the whole round. But I think it was a good point.
Thank you.
Ian said he likes Hitch. He said that it's not that he doesn't like it. It's just that he's kind of seen something similar before. I might want to hear an example of that in the next round if you can come up with one that's just kind of in that same ballpark. You said it's funny. You said it's good, but is it original? You also said Kevin James's fat guy dances like Chris Farley's. I appreciated that. There's a lot of range in I Am Legend. So I think that had some really good moments in it. This right here in the third round, this is where we kind of just put a button on it. You can respond to critiques that were made against your film. You can just kind of flesh out your general argument, tie things up however you want to approach it. Alex might have some very out of the box, unorthodox way of going about this third round, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm here for it, man. So we're gonna go ahead and start this round off with Ian. This is round three, and we'll go ahead and start the clock in 3, 2, 1, and go.
What Alex is gonna say? Well, I don't even think Alex even knew this fact, but I Am Legend Legend is actually a remake of the Omega Man. A lot of people don't know this. And I actually did like the Omega Man. It came out in 1964. Obviously, I wasn't alive for that. Jeremy was, though. But I remember seeing the remake, seeing that with my mother as a child. I liked it. Will Smith made it his own. Will Smith, in my opinion, did a better job at it. So a lot of people don't talk about the Omega Man because Will Smith made his own. Now let's talk about Hitch, how similar it is to other movies. The first thing I thought about is 51st States. Definitely a different premise. It's about, you know, memory and stuff like that. But still, it has that vibe of the guy trying to get the girl, and he's got weirdos around him trying to help.
Need to get your facts right.
So I think that one, along came Polly. Shoot, I got a whole list of them.
That's good.
Just Friends. You know, I can go all day. Just go with it. And I don't know. With just most of Adam Sandler's movies. You know, this was just basically an Adam Sandler movie with Will Smith instead doing his ha-ha, Big Willie style shit. But another critique I have about of Hitch, I think it was good enough to get a sequel, but just Will Smith just didn't want to do it. I would have loved to see more of that. You can't do a sequel to I Am Legend. It's a one take. It's a one-off thing. You can't do that. It's great. So in conclusion, I don't even think Hitch is even Will Smith's top five movies. I would definitely went with Pursuit of Happiness, The First Independence Day, Men in Black, My Movie. Did I say I Am Legend? Oh, that four, what is it, 8 pounds? The one with the
7 pounds.
7 pounds. I apologize. Hope I don't get anything up, but I'm not talking about that movie. But my point is, I don't even think Hitch is in the top five. Top 10, I'll give you that. But top five Will Smith movies, I think it's teeter tottering on six or seven.
Ouch. That one hurt me, dude. All right. Ian, you made some good points in that round. You mentioned the Omega Man, which actually stars Charlton Heston, the same guy that was in
Planet of the Apes.
Yeah. Yep. And you said Will Smith did better than Charlton Heston. And I don't think that's tough to agree with. So that's quite a testament. You said 51st Dates, Along Came Polly, Just Friends. You said that Hitch is an Adam Sandler movie without Adam Sandler in it. And that's not good. I Am Legend is a one and done. You can't do sequels to it. It's just kind of exists in its own space.
I didn't mean to interrupt you, but I just realized Adam Sandler does a lot of stuff with Kevin James. I didn't even, you know, put that point in until you just said it out loud. So God, it really is.
So you also named several movies that you think are better and some compelling names on that list, but that's not what I'm here to discuss, because we're here to look at things objectively in terms of the arguments themselves and not what my personal preference is, which is that Wild Wild West is the best Will Smith movie of all time.
Yo, that's guilty pleasure, though. I love that song.
That's a guilty pleasure for me, too.
Yeah, it's a trash movie, but I actually enjoy it.
And that soundtrack, yeah. Ooh.
Yes. Oh my God. It's the Wild Wild West.
All right, Alex, you've got 2 minutes to wrap this thing up. You've got some good arguments so far. I'm curious to hear how this goes at the very end. In 3, 2, 1, and go.
So Ian initially said that, you know, my movie is essentially like other, you know, relationship movies. So is I Am Legend. Have we not seen movies like World War Z, where a pandemic happened first, and people were disappeared and turned into zombies? Or like, let's take a current event movie like Outbreak, or the Netflix movie Pandemic, or like literally there have been end of the world movies where an actor had to act by himself.
And Legend was 2007.
To get to their objective, okay? So let's just put it, I'm gonna put this out there. Yes, I Am Legend is definitely, if not top five, top 10. But the reason why I mentioned Hitch is because of the fact it is an underrated Will Smith movie that's not what's talked about. It's giving, and it's funny, it's not focused on really Black men getting women. It's focused on every man getting women. And the fact that I, as a man, have to struggle out of getting out of my own head to get the woman that I want is a thing that people go through, even through a pandemic. A pandemic is what we're going through right now.
You know what? This is really kind of distracting, and I haven't gotten laid in a year.
It's a little bit more relatable. And then the thing is that the very thing that Will Smith, it's like Will Smith is playing upon himself. He's coaching people to get these women, but he's struggling through the same thing. And it's like, it's like even his own teachings are not working as well as he thought. Oh! Oh! Whoa! So for me, it was cool to see, in a sense, Will Smith played two characters in the same movie, the coach, but also the recipient of having to learn the things that I'm telling people what to do. So for me, as a film, I love the progression of Hitch. There's a brotherly bond that he had with Paul. Well, I call him Paul Blart because of Mall Cop, but Kevin James.
And like, time. Yeah. That's it. Well done, man. Well done. You really put it together in this third round. I think that was really
well done.
You definitely
got to give him a
point
for calling him Paul Blart, because a lot of people do that too.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Hitch, the world's first fresh and fit. Glad that we have people like him and Mystery out here.
I'm done. I lost. Good one. I lost.
Good one.
Clean your room, young man. I'm fucking Jordan Peterson. All right, so Alex, you had some good points. You said not all, maybe Hitch isn't the most original, but let's be honest, we've seen End of the World movies before. You actually named a couple of other ones. Yeah, Ian,
yeah,
you
named
right.
A lot after the year 2007.
Several of them did post-date it. However, Omega Man is yes, you know, the same movie.
I'll give you that.
Wait, Pandemic actually came out in 2020. That's a Netflix
movie. That, throw that out there. The classic film Pandemic. You said it's focused on the everyman, and not only that, it's underrated, not really talked about. You said it's kind of uplifting, and it's Will Smith. I thought this was really interesting. You said it's Will Smith kind of like using his own charisma, but he's also dealing with the same things that he's talking about. If I'm not mistaken, the whole point of Hitch was that you can't like be a pickup artist. You got to be authentic. You got to be real. So this idea of what Hitch was, I think is kind of deconstructed by the end, but I do think that's really cool how you said he's two different characters at once, even though it's just one guy. So interesting approach. I appreciated that. I thought it was a really good third round. And you know, I've kind of been recapping as we go, that way I don't have to dive too deep into it during the deliberations, but I do like how when we do this and Alex is moderating, he'll break it down round by round. So let's do it in terms of that. And we'll kind of see who won each. And if we do indeed need to go into a sudden death at the finale of the season. All right. So in round one, both of you guys made a pretty comparable amount of points. In terms of who made more points, I think Alex was really able to just get in there and say a lot of stuff in the same amount of time frame. I think Ian had some just really good points in the first round. I think he set it up really well. So without spending a lot of time on the deliberating, I think round one goes to Ian. I don't think by much, but I think that there was enough of a margin there that I'm pretty confident calling it in that direction. round two. Wow. Wow. Wowie. Wowie. This was interesting because I appreciate the fact that you went outside the box on this. I really do. I think that was a bold choice. It was funny.
That was hilarious.
I think you did yourself a disservice, though, because Ian didn't use the points that you said.
I did.
Oh, God, I had my own points. You literally said none of them. I was like, okay.
So what happened is now Ian had 10 reasons, and you gave him an extra 5, bro.
Exactly.
That was funny, though. It was hilarious.
It was.
Very entertaining. I knew what you were doing, that 8 Mile shit. I loved it.
It was good. It was a good round.
I thought about it because when we did the Fast and Furious debate, that's all Jeremy did the whole time. That's the whole time. I was just like, I'm going to take this perspective. I was like, I'm going to do this.
Yeah, dude. And that didn't work out well for me either, if I recall.
Yeah, to be fair.
So, yeah, man, round two went to Ian for sure. Then something interesting happened in round three, and I think Ian was kind of stuck in a little bit of a loop at the end. And that happens sometimes because we're kind of just trying to find different ways of saying the same thing again. Round three can be tough sometimes, but yes. You know, Ian did talk about, like I mentioned earlier, Will Smith being better than Charlton Heston. I think that is a real testament to the performance of Will Smith. And I really like that third argument. However, Alex, you had some just really good counters in there. Anything that Ian was able to bring up in round three, you kind of addressed it in your final argument, and you brought in new elements to the discussion. So I think your round three was excellent, and I think you definitely ran away with that one. However, if I'm looking at the score here, I'm pretty confident saying that the winner of this final episode of season three of Real Debates is Ian Elliott Carter.
Oh my goodness.
Winner.
Props to Alex for doing Hitch on the Fly, though, because I know he was ready to do what's it called? The other one.
Concussion. Like I was yeah. juggling between actually Hitch and Concussion. I like Hitch a little bit more because I recently just saw it. But I was just like, I don't know if Ian has seen Concussion. So I wanted to do a movie that I know we've both seen. And I love I Am Legend. That's like, I watch that almost every year. It's so good.
Yeah, really. I'm glad you got this option of Will Smith movies, because like I feel like he's gotten a lot of flack and hate in the last couple of years. And people have done forgot he gets busy.
Oh, man. Like, yeah. I mean, I could have went with Hancock, but I don't know why people shit on that movie.
We just
that
watched Hancock the other day, too. I don't like the ending of Hancock. I think it's one of the stupidest endings, but it's a strong beginning, though.
Right. I would love to see him fight Superman. We know that would never happen, but
it's like in the 1980s, I think you could say it was pretty much the decade of Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yep.
In the 2000s, you could say were the decade of The Rock. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, there's these quintessential stars through the 90s. It was Will Smith, dude. He was the most bankable, highest paid actor in Hollywood. And yeah, and post that, he started doing a lot of those more kind of dramatic movies, starting with Ali. Like, the dude's good. The dude is very good. So definite respect to Will Smith for sure.
Yeah, you know what? Damn, now looking back, I should have chose Ali, because I just
wanted
that.
Didn't you fight Ali before?
I did. Yeah. That was the original.
Another one better than Hitch. No, I'm just kidding. I actually think Hitch is better than Ali, but Ali's really like, that was probably his first one that we're like, yo, he can act.
Yeah. That more dude, than just the Fresh Prince. He became Muhammad Ali.
Yeah.
And even though I can't really see him as Muhammad Ali when I put them side by side, but I watched that movie, I was like, holy shit.
Yes.
Like, that's Muhammad Ali. But there you have it, you guys. Ian is our winner for season three. I had so much fun doing this season. I can't wait for us to come back for season four. If the graphics for season three and the funny moments and the laughing and the instant replays will carry on into season four. I'm so glad you guys keep coming back and you guys keep messaging me. And also, I want to point this out before we close. This would not be a reality if it was not for Jeremy and Ian. Because when people ask, like, because I've had some of you ask, did I create this? I did not create this. I added my creative spin to it, but I feel like this was more so a collaborative effort.
Yes.
So I could 100%. Never take 100% credit for any of this, because like, again, this wouldn't be where it is if it wasn't for these guys. So I do appreciate you guys being a part of this journey. Absolutely. With me.
We appreciate you, big homie.
Yeah, man.
Anytime, man. I can't wait for us to do season four, bigger and better, hopefully. And oh, by the way, before we wrap up, I'm gonna call out a few people for season four.
Oh, I was gonna do the same. Go ahead, let's do it.
Holden, I know you're watching this. I know we don't have to discuss what happened in season two, but we want the smoke again. Sean Chandler, we were talking during season three. Come see me, brother. Come see me. And also, one other person who I'm trying to get for season four, John Rocha. Come see me, brother.
Let's
come
go, Rocha.
See me.
I got one. I've collaborated with this brother, and he's a really good dude. One of my favorite YouTubers. Ryan Airy of Screen Crush.
Oh,
let's do this, buddy. Let's do this. If you watching this, man, you are one of the best breakdown guys in the game. But I'll spank that ass when it comes to movie debates. Let's do it.
There is one other person. I forgot his name already. Just had in my head it was gone, but I'm sure he'll come back up. But I can't wait to do season four. I'm going to try to get some of those big name guests on the show. But it, again, it's been such a fun ride. Thank you guys again for being part of the show. Real quick, where can we find both of you guys on social media and our champion? Who? Where can we find you on social media?
Oh, man. I_controversy at Twitter and Instagram. Check me out. I got my link to my YouTube in the bio. And you can watch it in the bio if you want, if you're from New Orleans. But yeah, I have dope content. I'm going to be collaborating with these guys, hopefully. This is the beginning of the year, hopefully throughout the year. And yeah, much love, peace, and chicken grease.
Awesome. And Jeremy, where can we find you on social media?
Check out Jeremy G Branch on Twitter. I'm trying to rebuild a community. I recently lost my account on Twitter, so do me the follow. Head over and check out Jeremy G Branch on Twitter, and also Movies Are Terrible on YouTube.
Awesome. And you know where to find us here, guys, here at Momentum Media on YouTube. Thank you guys for watching this video, and as always, you guys have a blessed day.